Okay, so today I'm going to teach you how to create a work breakdown structure using Microsoft Project and Microsoft Visio. But before we go into the main activities, let's recap what is a work breakdown structure. Right, so it's simple. A work breakdown structure is composition of the different activities that form our project, and is typically represented like in this slide, like in the form of a tree diagram. In the upper levels, we have the summary task, which is the entire project. And as we go into the lower levels, we have the different activities that form our project. Now, remember, when we are making a work breakdown structure, we always try to keep in mind the MECE principle, which is mutually exclusive, collectively exhaustive. That means that all of the activities that form the lower levels of the tree, all the sum of these activities, they must form the entire work that is related to our project. But also, there should not be any overlap between the work of different activities, okay? So always keep in mind the MECE principle. Now, for today's example, we're going to be working with a simple house, and let me talk to you about this house. So for this house, we're going to obviously have some foundations. So here we have the foundations of the house. But this house is also going to have a pool. So we have the foundations of the pool. And these are two different separate activities. We're also going to have some walls, and here we have four walls. We're going to have a pool, we're going to have the roof of the house, and we're going to have some solar panels. Now, obviously, we're also going to have some interior designs and finishing. So this is the example that we are going to be working with. All right, so to produce the work breakdown structure, we're going to need some data. And here we have the project, the house that we were talking about. And here we have the data already in Microsoft Project. And here in this column, we have the work breakdown structure level for each one of these activities. So here, for example, we can see that the foundations of the house, it's on the level 1.1.1. That means that it belongs to the level 1.1, which is the house. And here we can notice that if we collapse the house, well, the foundations of the house is inside. So how we can export this data? Well, pretty simple. We go here to File. We click on Export. And we're going to choose Save Project as File. Here we're going to select Microsoft Excel Workbook. And we're going to click on Save As. So here we are going to, we can put it in whatever we want. For example, let's put it in the desktop. And now Microsoft Project is going to open the export wizard. So we're going to click here on next. We're going to select the data that we want to export. So we're going to manually tell Microsoft Project which data we want. So we click here next. A new map, because we don't have any pre-existing map. If we are doing this pretty commonly, we will have an existing map, but in our case, let's create a new one. And here we're going to start establishing, click on the different categories of data that we want to export. In our case, we want to export the activity names and the work breakdown structure level, which belong to the task category. Okay, so we're going to click here on task. We're going to click on next. And now we're going to choose what we want. Well, what we want, it's the name of the activity. So we search for name. And we can see that now we have a new column here, and we're going to add a new column, which is going to be the WBS. And we just select WBS, and here we have it. We have the name of the activity and the work breakdown structure level. So now I have everything that I need. I'm going to click on Finish. And now if I look in my desktop, I am going to have my new house Excel file with the data that I ask. Okay, good. We have the data, but this is not enough. We're going to have to transform this data to put it in the format of Microsoft Visio. So here we have our Excel file, the one that we just exported. And now we are going to have to make some work here, because our goal is to create a column that is going to tell us, okay, for this activity, which one is the parent? Okay, so from where we can find this information? Well, this information is here inside the work breakdown structure level. For example, this activity, it's 1.1. We know that the last dot is telling me the new level for the activity, and all of the values to the left of the last dot are actually the parent of this activity. So in this case, for example, this is activity 1.1. The parent of this activity, it's activity just one, which is true. It's just the project. So the same situation here. For example, the foundations of the house. Here, if I stop in the last dot, the pattern is 1.1, which is just the house. Okay, so perfect. I have this. Now, what I need to do is to transform, to be able to extract this information. So we need to do a lot of things in Excel. So we're going to do them step by step. The first thing that we need to do is to calculate the number of dots that we have in this string. So let's create a new column. Let's call it number of dots. I mean, to make it clear, actually, this is uppercase unnecessarily. Perfect. Okay. So how we're going to do this? Well, we're going to use a formula from Excel called substitute. And what we want to do is grab the text and substitute the dots for nothing. Okay. So that's what we're going to do. We substitute for nothing. And we're going to calculate the length of the text that we obtain. Okay, so for example, if I calculate the length here in the first row, since there is no dot to substitute, the length is the same. But for the new levels, we have a difference. Okay, so this is some new length. So this is something that we can actually use to our advantage. So if we grab the original length of my text. Yeah, so actually let's go to this one. So if I go ahead and grab the original length of my text and I subtract the length of the new text that I substituted the dots with nothing, I should get the number of dots. So for example, in the first one, I have no dots, so this is giving me 0. In the second one, I have only one dot, and this is giving me 1. And here, 2 and 2. Okay, good. So this is working. Great. Now, why I would like to do this? Well, it's because now what I want to do is to be able to substitute the last dot, which is equivalent to this number, with a special symbol. Okay, so here we're going to create, let's put a substitute last dot. I mean, just to give it a name to this step. So we're going to use a substitute again, and we are going to substitute, yeah, so this text, we're going to substitute dot by, let's put an special symbol, let's use the hash symbol, for example, and here on the last argument of this function, we can specify which instance of the appearance of this dot we want to substitute. So in this case, well, which is the one that we want to use? Well, here. In this case, is the number 0. But for example, we want to substitute the second dot of this string, and here the first one, and so on. So we're going to just use this number that we just calculated to get the substitution. Of course, for the first one, it's giving me an error because I have no dot to substitute. But for the next one, you can see that the last dot is replaced with the hash symbol. And later on, I'm going to teach you how we can handle this this error. But right now, here, we accomplish this. Okay, great. So now, we substituted, we mark the last dot with the hash symbol. So now we just need to find where is the location of this hash symbol. Okay, so let's put location hash. Okay, so we just need to determine where is located the hash symbol. So here we're going to use another formula for Excel, which is just fine. We just need to tell, well, what we need to find. And in this case, we want to find the hash symbol. And we want to find the hash symbol in which phrase? Well, the one that we just created. So of course, I have an error here, but in the next one, is telling me where is located the hash symbol. And here is in the second position, here in the fourth, and so on. So great, I have the location. So what I want to produce is just the text that is just left to the hash symbol. So how can I obtain that? Well, here I can get left text. That's gonna be easy because we have a special function in Excel called left. That allows me to just do that. I just need to specify the text from which I want to get the text. So in this case is this one. And how many characters I want to get? Well, I just want to get all of the characters from the hash symbol minus 1 because I don't want to get the hash symbol. So I put this I'm still having an error for the first row, but for the next one, I am obtaining exactly the text that I want. Just the text to the left of the point, okay? So, great, I am obtaining the pattern level of the word breakdown structure, but this is not yet what I want. What I would like here is, for example, not having a one, but I will have to, I would like to have just the phrase house. And for example, the foundations of the house, I know that the pattern is the house, so what I want is the house. So how can we get this? Well, first we're gonna need to find this word breakdown structure level, what is located in this column. So we're going to create a new column called index, and we're gonna use a formula in Excel called index. This is going to tell me exactly the location in the rows of the value that I'm looking. So I'm going to be saying, hey, I want to look, and actually no, first what I need is called match. I just need to match this text in this column. So we're gonna use match, sorry for that. So the value that we're going to be looking is this one. Where we're going to be looking it? Well, here in the word breakdown structure level, and we are going to use the dollar symbols symbols to fix these columns. And yes, we want an exact match, so yeah, that's perfect. So of course, again, an error for the first row, but for the next one, it's telling me that, okay, look, the value one is actually located in the first position, in the first row of this column. Great. So now, this is going to be really nice. I can combine this match with another function called index. And here I'm going to call the function index. And what I want to tell is, look, from this array, now this one, and I'm also going to put it in between the dollar symbols, get me this index position. Okay? So do this. I do it for the next columns, and there you have it. I have exactly what I'm looking. The house, the parent, is exactly this project. So let's actually call this new column parent, and here I have it. Now, to catch this error and to avoid something as nasty as this, we can enclose this with another formula in Excel called if error. Okay? So if error. So we provide the value that happens if there is no error. And if there is error, what do we want? Well, let's put nothing, okay? If there is an error, this is going to be filled with nothing, okay? So here we put it in all the rows, and here we have it. The error was catched because it's giving me nothing. And for the next one, it's giving me exactly what I want. So I have my column with the parent and with the original activity. So what I need to do now is, if I want to use this data into Microsoft Visio, we actually need a new file. So let's create a new Excel file, a blank one. And here we're going to create the new columns that we need. So here we're going to put name. We're going to put report 2, because that's what Visio wants. And here we're going to copy the name of the activities, and here in this other column we're going to put the pattern activities that we just calculated. And here, when we're going to paste them, we're going to paste them as values. We don't want to paste the formula, okay? So now we're going to save this. Let's save it again in the desktop. So yeah, let's call it a WBS in MS Visio. Okay, so we put it in the desktop. Good. And there we have our data. We're going to close this. We are going to save this because we made all of this effort for the formulas. So now here we are in the interface of Microsoft Visio. So what we're going to use to create our word breakdown structure is to click here on organizational chart. So we click here, we select the first option using the chart wizard. So we click here on create. And now we need to select from where we're going to get the data, okay? So our data is in a database, it's an Excel file. So we're gonna select the first option. We click next. Then we select that we are going to use an Excel file. We click next. We're going to locate where is our Excel file, and we put it in the desktop. Remember, it's this one, WBS in MS Visio. So we click open, we click next. All right, so here we have name, and now we just need to select that is reporting, okay? So here we have the two columns. One should be name, and the other one reports to. So we click here, next. This is looking okay. Here again, okay. Okay, we don't need any pictures. No, we are not going to use any pictures. So we click on next. And the top level of our work breakdown structure is the project activity, the entire project. So we're going to use this one. So we put here project, and then we click on finish. And now all of the data is imported, and here we have it, okay? So first things that we can change, we can select this, and again, we don't want any pictures because these activities are not going to have any pictures. So we select all of them, and we click here on delete. Okay, we have it here. We can, for example, select the type of boxes that we want. I would like to have this type of boxes. So I click here. It's going to change that for all of the activities. Good. And here, perhaps, I can change the layout. Let's have a more like a balanced layout. So we're going to use the center one. And here we have it. Okay, good. And we could also, for example, we can select all of the activities and increase the size of the text. I mean, we have the space, so we can go here to home and increase a little bit the size of the text. I mean, just for visibility, and there we have it. This is our work breakdown structure. So now we just need to save it as we want. Let's call it here WBS. Let's put it again in the desktop. And we can also print it. For example, we can print it as a PDF and share it with other people in our organization. So I hope you liked this video and that you learned how to make a visual work breakdown structure using Microsoft Project and Visio. And I will see you in the next video. Thank you.